very, very warm welcome to Singapore. It's the former home of Singapore football, the Jalan Besar Stadium, for the 23rd Cannon Lion City Cup 2011. And we will have six teams vying in two groups to see who will make it through to the big final next Sunday. But kicking us off is Group A action. It's Newcastle United. They're under 15 side participate in this tournament. Joining me in the commentary position is former Cambodian national team manager, Mr. Scott O'Donnell. Scotty, good to have you here.
Yeah, it's great to be here, Paul. I'm really excited about this competition, seeing some of the best young players from England, from Brazil, from Italy, and of course Singapore.
You're seasoned, you've been out here long enough, Scott, to know and understand. How difficult are the foreign teams going to come here to Singapore to play in this competition, find it to adapt because of the weather conditions? Into the box. Is it going to be good enough? It's just been dangerous with the internet near post. And it's been going in. Yes, it has. What early drama here at the Jalan Besar Stadium in the 23rd Cannon Lion City Cup. The goalkeeper, who normally makes good decisions and in the press this week, has been touted.
Billy there picked the pocket. It was a wonderful piece of skill from him. He goes for the return. He's one on one with that kid again.
What a save. That's better from the keeper on that occasion. Danger not putting it, though. One block. That was from Mahathir on that occasion. Well, real time as he goes straight at the other end, and a chance here for Azar, bearing down on goal. Azar with a flip, tried to catch out Sam Busby in goal and flip it over him. But that was entertaining and entertaining. There is the man that had scored the equalising goal some 9 minutes ago. It was, of course, great work for our Ramley, but Zulfadmi had cut in from the right. Ramley gets dispossessed, and again a chance. It's a lovely ball straight forwards, and it's clear that what a challenge that was. Sadik had to get that 100% spot on, because it was booked a few minutes ago. But a chance here for Singapore to swing into action at the other end. Great ball played inside. Swandy!
Well, it's end-to-end action here. Sadik pulling off a great sliding tackle there. And as you said, Paul, it needed to be timed to perfection because he does have a yellow card. But look at Adam Swandy here. Great creating yard box. Great piece of skill. You can see him there. Beat the defender. Hands down. Just that final shot with his left peg was
a little bit quicker. And that gone short as well. And it's just draining there. Set up the goal for Singapore. Really had an opportunity there to do exactly the same, if not hit the back of the net. And that is a chance that's gone wasted.
Once again, Adam Swansea playing a great ball in behind the defence. And as it's causing all sorts of problems, but just lacking the composure in that attacking third. But he's causing
the blue shirts. Here's Mounami. Skips past one challenge. There's a little bit of contact. And this is a dangerous position here, because we do know that Zulfadmi Suzerman can strike a ball. He's attacked quickly. Oh, and he's been drilled. And it's hit the crossbar by Ivan Sasihara. Warming up. Away to our left-hand side. Here's Swadi. Adam Swadi. Little step over. Lovely little give and go. Swadi! He's pulled it just wide. What a chance that was for the young starlet from Singapore. It really has been a pleasure to watch so far. And the one thing that's let him down today is just that final touch stuff, because everything else has been impeccable. Yeah, great to watch football. You can see there,
Swansea there. He's finishing letting him down, but great piece of skill, great little give and go.
Chance there for Singapore again to try and score and equalise this game. But they do have an artificial pitch, but obviously the standard and quality of the pitches that they play on back in England are superb.
Great opportunity there for Irfan. That first touch we played
a nonchalant swing of the hips, just sucks all the defenders in, but that's a great ball flag forwards. Is Gilly. Gilly is through. What a moment to kick up. Gilly! Makes no mistake at this time. You may have thought that that's what he should have done in the first half, but again he showed his power of pace coming up against Arvin and really, really finished it well. He was looking and struggling with a calf about 2 minutes.
Malasa gets in, forces his way into the box, great ball in, and that was a little mistake for the keeper.
And struck it just wide by Alex Gilly. What a real chance for him to make the name for himself. But unfortunately, he's pulled back just wide, and again, he goes down with cramp, and you just wonder if we have seen the last of Alex Gilly today.
You can see the pain he's in. It's a cramp in the calf muscle, but it was Barlasse down the right-hand side. Scheifel would be disappointed if he didn't get hold of that. And I'm just a little bit surprised, Gilly. I don't want to be too critical of him, but I think he may have been better off striking that with his left foot rather than his right. You can see he's shaped his body to try and get down to the near post. May have been better off going back across the face.
The corner for Singapore, taken short. Zulfadmi gives possession. Swansea pulls it back to the penalty spot, and there's a goal. And we could have a late draw here. Stabbed home with a man that really shot in the first half. Azhar Bamley had some really good looks this second half, but he's got his name on the score sheet. More importantly, he's got his team back into this tie.
Thank you.
Easy. Well, given away again to Andy. Jim's passed on. Great goal.